If you're looking for a great way to manage customer service for your business, you've come to the right video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up a customer support form inside of Notion, have it embedded on a live page that you can share with your customers, and then have those support form entries submitted to a Notion database that your team can go ahead and work together on to make sure that all of the customer issues are resolved for your business. Let's get started from scratch. First off, we're going to create a database in Notion so that whenever an entry is submitted on the form, it is sent here to Notion so that your team can view it. I'm going to name this database support cases, and I'm going to select table. We're then going to create a new database. Let's go ahead and remove this tags property, and then let's change name from name to subject. Then let's create a status field so we can go ahead and mark whether or not we are currently resolving this issue for the customer. Not started, in progress, and done are just fine for now. Then let's create two date fields, one to show whenever a case was opened versus when our team resolved it. So I'm going to enter date, and then this one is going to be open date. And then let's create another one that is called closed date. Let's also add a priority field. So let's do a select, and then we're going to name this one priority, and let's give it the options of low, medium, and high. This will allow you and your team to mark which ones are most important for you to focus on and create views inside of Notion that are making sure that you're tackling these first. Now let's also create a field called type, and this type field is going to be used to allow us to categorize what type of issue this is. So we're going to name it type, and then let's also add another field called subtype to drill even further down into this type so we can get really specific with issues. And this will make a little bit more sense here in a second once I start adding some values. But for now, let's go ahead and do subtype. So for type, I'm going to enter three generic types of cases that most businesses come across. But obviously, you can enter more options here that you personally come across on a daily basis while working. But first off, I'm going to add a type of case is billing. So I'm going to search for the card emoji, and then I'm going to enter billing. Next up, let's do product. So this would represent any issues with the product itself. Maybe there's a bug. And then next up, we're going to do feedback just to give our customers a chance to say anything that they think can help improve our service. Now that we have those three options, let's go ahead and enter subtypes underneath each one of these. So I'm going to put these here so we can see them. And then let's go to subtype, and we're going to edit the properties. And underneath feedback, let's go ahead and enter one of the options as user experience enhancement. Next up, let's do product improvement suggestion. Then let's do feature request. So that's the subtypes we'll have for feedback. And one thing I like to do is make them color coordinated. So let's make these all yellow for the feedback. And then let's work on the product subtypes. So again, I'm going to put the iPhone emoji there, and then let's do product description, technical product issue, product usage guidance, and then product information. Again, let's go ahead and make sure all of these are color coordinated. So I'm going to make them all blue. And now let's finish off the subtypes with the billing. So we're going to do billing dispute as one of them, then payment issue, and then billing inquiry. And you probably noticed this by now, I accidentally messed up on the colors. So actually, the product should be purple. I'm going to go ahead and make that adjustment here. And so how they're going to come into the form is people are going to select feedback as an example, and the options that they're presented with are feature request, product improvement suggestion, and user experience enhancement. And then it would come under here in your system, and then you can create views off of the different types of cases that are coming in. And this is going to allow you to hone in on specific types of cases that might be taking longer for your team to resolve, and that maybe you need to really focus on improving something in your process or in your product. Now we're also going to add an email field, and this is going to allow us to capture the person who's submitting their email. And then we also want their name. So we're gonna enter full name here so we can capture that. And to make this system very valuable, I would recommend setting up a Notion CRM within your workspace so that you can tie these cases to your clients. If you don't already have a Notion CRM within your workspace, no worries, you can get a free one in the description of this video. And I built it using my experience as a certified CRM consultant. Or if you prefer to build one yourself, I have a very detailed video on my channel on how to build a CRM from scratch. So if you do decide to set up a CRM, I'd go ahead and create a relationship here as well. And we are going to tie it to whatever you have named as your client database. So I'm going to search for accounts. And this is the one that I would select, and I would show on accounts as well. And what this is going to allow me to do is see all of the cases related to my customers over time. So add relation. Let's also add in a few automations here before we start building out the form. So we're going to hit the lightning button up here on the database, and then we're going to create a new automation. And what we're going to do for this first one is whenever a case is open, we're automatically going to timestamp the open date with now. So name this one timestamp open date. For the trigger, we're going to select whenever a page is added. And then the action is we're going to select open date, and we're going to set the open date to now. And now let's create another automation for whenever the status is moved to complete, that it's automatically going to timestamp that close date as well. So let's hit the lightning button again, hit new automation, and then let's name this one close date timestamp. For the trigger, it's going to be whenever the status is moved to complete, hit done. And then whenever it is moved to complete, we're again going to have the close date set to now. Then select create. And then this next automation is optional. If your team uses Slack, I would highly recommend creating an automation that notifies a Slack channel whenever a case comes in, so that your team is making sure that they're resolving it as fast as possible. So we're going to name this one send Slack notification. For the trigger, it's going to be whenever a page is added. And then the action is we're going to send a Slack notification too. And you need to set up your Slack account to be able to do this if you have it integrated already. I do have a video on the channel if you're interested on how to do that. But I'm just going to send a notification to my general channel to let me know that someone's submitted a case. So let's create this Slack notification. And now we want to create a formula that's going to allow us to be able to tell what's the difference between the open date and the close date, so we can track over time how fast we're resolving certain issues. So again, we're going to come over and create another property in the Notion database, but this time we're going to select formula, and then we're going to name this one turnaround time, edit the formula, and then I'm going to be sharing this in the description of the video. And it's this formula here. And if this formula is confusing you, I have another video on my channel that covers date time formulas in Notion, so definitely check that out so you can learn how to create this yourself. But once you've entered this formula in here, we're going to hit done. And then let's move it over next to the open date and the close date. And then let's just create a fake test case real quick so you can see how this all works. So I'm just going to add a row in here, and let's say that this is something that's wrong with the credit card. So credit card issue is the name of it. And then you can see that it's automatically timestamped that open date here. For this, we would want to probably decide what the priority is automatically when it's always this type of issue. But whenever it's submitted from the form that we're going to be creating, it's going to be a billing, and then it would be something along the lines of payment issue. And then all of their information is going to be entered in over here. But I also just want to show you while I'm here, the automation that we just built. So when I go to status and I hit done, what it's going to do is going to timestamp that close date with now. And then you can see it's only been a difference of 1 minute from when it was opened to closed. Before we move on to building the form, I'd probably just add like an icon here as well. So I think that this headset one's perfect for support. And then whenever I first create a database, I like just to name it all, so I can get a view where I have all records inside a database. And then I can drill down on different sort of filters and other types of views. But on this, let's actually also enter in that headset too, and then we should be good. Let's work on building the form together. And the form builder that I recommend using with this support database that we just created is Tally, because they have a really good integration with Notion where you can actually embed the forms within Notion pages. And it's a great free option for small business owners. Obviously, they have some sort of functionality that you need to pay for, but I think for most of you out there, this will be just fine. And of course, if you're using some other type of form builder, you can usually connect it to Notion either through a direct integration or through one through Make or Zapier. So make sure you sign up for an account if you don't have one already, and then let's start working on the form together. After you've created your account, you should be able to come to a page just like this. And you notice that Tally is actually very similar to Notion in some ways. So first off, we're going to give the form a title. So let's name this one customer support. Let's go ahead and press enter to start from scratch. And then just like Notion, we do slashes and then we search up whatever we want to add to the page. So I'm going to do a slash. Then I'm going to scroll down here to the bottom, and we're going to do question plus short answer. So for this this one, we're going to find their full name. So we're going to ask them for their full name. And then again, underneath this one here, we're going to press plus and we're going to do an email. So we're going to try to get their email and insert it. And it looks like it didn't come with the heading. So I'm just going to find a heading 3, insert it, and we're going to name this one email. Sometimes it's best actually to say business email, just so people aren't getting your Gmails and never responding. Then again, we're going to do a slash, and then we're going to go down and we're going to search for question plus dropdown. So you're going to select this one, and this one is going to be type. Then let's add in those types that we added on the other form. So we're going to do billing is one of them. The other one is going to be feedback. And then the third is going to be product. Now let's again select another question plus drop down, insert it, and then this one is going to be for the subtype. I had a total of 10 different subtypes. You might have something different, that's totally fine, but go ahead and add all of them as options here. After you've entered in all of your subtypes, we're going to come up here to type and click the 6 circles, and we're going to add some conditional logic. And what this logic is going to do is that whenever billing is selected, you're only presented with the billing options of subtype, and same thing goes for feedback and product. So when type is, we're going to select the option billing, then select action, hide blocks, and we're going to select all the blocks that aren't billing related. So I have my 3 billing ones here on the bottom, so I'm going to select all the other ones here underneath subtype. And then again, for feedback, let's do the same thing. We're going to add conditional logic. And so this time when type is feedback, then hide blocks. We're going to hide everything but the feedback options that I have. And then finally, let's add the conditional logic for product. So type is product, then hide blocks, these 3, and then these 3 as well. Next up, let's add a field for someone to enter the subject of the issue that they are coming across or the feedback. So we're going to do question plus short answer, insert it. And we're going to name this one subject. And then underneath this, we are going to do another question, but this time it's going to be a long answer. And this is going to give your customer the option to be able to go into more detail about what is the issue that they're coming across. So for this, for the question, let's say, please provide a detailed explanation of what's going on. So I just said something along the lines of, please provide a detailed explanation of your support inquiry. Okay, now that we have all the fields, let's go ahead and look at a little preview first, make sure everything looks good. So we have that full name, the business email, type, subtype, subject, and then that long description field. Let's take a look at those types, make sure everything looks good. So when I select billing, I'm only given those billing options. For feedback, only given feedback options. And then for product, only given product options. So that looks good. So what we're going to do from here is you're going to go ahead and select publish, and then go to the integrations page and go ahead and connect Notion to Tally. You're going to go through the process of logging in with your account, and then you're just going to want to make sure that you give access to the page where the support database lives. And to confirm that the integration is set up properly, come over here to the page where the database is and hit the 3 circles here, and you should see Tally form set up here. If not, make sure you do add connections, search for Tally, and I've already added it, so it's not showing up there, but that's how you can make sure that it's showing up. Then select that database here, give it a name. Here you can see that your account is connected. Then first off, we're going to work on integrating that full name into the database. So select full name, and then we are going to map it with full name. Then let's keep going down the list. Let's go ahead and map subject with subject. Then let's go to that business email, and we're going to map it up with email. And then let's do type, map it up with type, and subtype. Again, let's map it up with subtype. Here in the page content, we're going to do an at, and then we're going to select that long form answer on the detailed explanation of the support inquiry. And in case you don't know what page content in Notion is, it's whenever you click in to a record, this section down here is the page content. So their long form answer is going to be put down here. Once you're done, connect with Notion, and then you can see that integration is set up properly. While you're on this page, let's go ahead and select share, and we're going to copy this share link. And what we're going to do is we're going to embed it in a page inside of Notion. Now head back over to Notion, and let's go ahead and create a empty page, and you can name this one customer support form. And then we're going to do a slash, and you're going to search for embed. And then we're going to take that link that we just got from Tally and we're going to embed it here. And then you can see it's put here on the page. And let's go ahead and make it as big as possible. It's up to you how big you want it. You can even make this page full width so it can go the full length, but I like it just like this and nice and clean. And one thing I've even done on my own personal one is I've added my logo. I think that makes it look a little bit better. But let's go ahead and again on this one that we're working on, let's add in the customer support icon. And then the way that you would share this with your customers is if you come up here to the top right of Notion, you can select share, and then you're going to go over to publish, and you're going to publish this to the web. And then this is a live link that you can go ahead and copy and you can give to your customers through email, or you can also put it on your website so that they can access this form and submit inquiries into your support database. So I've went ahead and it put that form inside of my browser, and then you can see this is what it looks like. So let's go ahead and submit an entry and see what happens. So we're going to do Benjamin Taylor as my name, then going to enter my email. Let's enter that type. So we're going to do billing and then a billing dispute. For the subject, let's say like I was charged too much, and then just add in a brief little explanation here for yourself so that you can see what it looks like on a record. After you've entered all of your data, go ahead and submit. And then if everything was set up correctly, it should have just sent a entry into your support database. And if you set up Slack notifications, you'll be getting a Slack notification that someone has reported an issue. So there we go. You can see that has now been entered in my database. I did make a mistake on the form side of not matching up the emojis. You probably want to do that whenever you're going through this scenario. But you can see that my email, my full name was put in here as well. And then whenever this case comes in, I'd simply just relate it to my CRM. So for this hypothetical scenario, I've gone ahead and tied my good friends over at Rotiv. Then of course, after we have this database set up and a lot of data is coming into it, we can of course create different views based off of who is the owner, what is the type, how long is it taking you to solve certain types of cases. And overall, I think this is going to give your business a really strong way to make sure that you're giving your customers the best services possible. If you'd like more Notion business tutorials just like this, don't forget to like and subscribe, and also drop in the comments below what types of things you would like me to build out for you guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.